Hi, I'm Veli from Greenwood Solutions. This week's presentation is on flow batteries. So after watching, you'll understand what they are. What's a flow battery? What are the pros of a flow battery and cons compared to other energy storage systems? If you like what you see, hit that subscription button, strap yourself in, let's get stuck into it. So what actually is a flow battery? So effectively, it's an electrical storage device that is a cross between a conventional battery and a fuel cell. Liquid electrolyte of metallic salts is pumped through a core that consists of a positive and negative electrode, separated by a membrane. The ion exchange that occurs between the cathode and anode generates electricity, and this liquid electrolyte is stored in external tanks. So with flow batteries, they've been around for a while, and like with any assessment of an energy storage system, you really have to look at a few things, and that's its, in no particular order, its longevity, its energy density, what it can actually deliver at any point in time and for how long, and also its physical footprint. Where's it going to go? The logistics of getting it to site. What about from an installation perspective? Flow batteries can cycle more often to a greater depth of discharge. In fact, up to 100% depth of discharge, with no negative effect on the battery's performance life. Flow batteries can store power for 4 hours or more and last for decades, up to 25 years before needing replacement. Most large commercial flow batteries use acid sulfur with vanadium salt as the electrolyte. The electrodes are made of graphite bipolar plates. Vanadium is one of the few available active materials that keeps corrosion under control. Flow batteries have been tried that contain precious metals such as platinum, which is also used in fuel cells. And research is continuing to find materials that are low cost and readily available. The physical nature of the flow battery is that it's fairly large, it has a big footprint, but that's not necessarily a bad thing if the site under consideration has plenty of room. Flow batteries perform best when they are above 20 kilowatt hours, vanadium flow batteries, and when they can deliver more than 10,000 full cycles. So they're good for about 20 years or 25 years. Each cell produces 1.15 to 1.55 volts, and they are connected in series to achieve the desired voltage levels. The batteries have a specific energy of about 40 watt hours per kilogram, which resembles lead acid. This makes the battery best suited for bulk energy storage. Vanadium is the 23rd element on the periodic table. It's currently mined in China, Russia, and South Africa. And Nevada, USA may soon become a contributor in the form of heavily oxidized crumbled rock. Currently, 90% of lower grade vanadium is used as an additive to strengthen steel, so chrome vanadium tools. So, a lot of analysts are seeing vanadium as being part of that green energy drive, very similar to lithium. But like with anything, if you mine something, you're invariably digging a big hole in the ground, and that the cost-benefit analysis from an environmental perspective and financial perspective must be taken into consideration. Manufacturers offer a variety of flow battery chemistries with different cells being developed, such as redox, hybrid, and membraneless. The redox battery stores energy in the liquid at all times. Hybrid flow batteries store at least some energy in solid metal during charge. In a membraneless flow battery, the liquid self-separates into one tank. As a rule, and relying upon the science, flow batteries will in general be less reactive, simple to dispose of, and are not inclined to overheating. So Brisbane-based company Redflow has developed the world's smallest zinc bromide flow battery, Z-cell, in commercial production, with operating temperatures of between 10 degrees and 50 degrees centigrade. So if the temperature falls outside this temperature range, the system shuts off. So obviously they need to have a thermal system to maintain electrolyte at above 10 degrees. This system can be discharged to 100% and can stay in a partial state of discharge forever, which is a decided advantage. The Redflow system is pretty interesting. from the perspective that it's Australian made, which is fantastic, and also it has a smaller footprint than the vanadium style of flow battery, which is much larger and designed for more utility scale and commercial applications. The other offering from the same company is the ZBM2. The ZBM2 has 10 kilowatt hours in energy storage capacity, can use 100% of its energy storage capacity daily, which is great news. The batteries are made from recycled or reused components. At the end of its life, the battery's electrolyte can be purified and used for new batteries. Each battery contains about 100 litres of water-based zinc bromide salt solution that circulates in two separate hydraulic circuits. When charging, zinc is extracted from the zinc bromide solution and stored on a plastic membrane. During discharge, zinc is released back to the solution. The benefit of this process is that it causes no degradation to the battery when zinc is removed at the end of each cycle, giving it a sustained long life energy storage capacity. With these batteries, you can discharge to 100% depth of discharge without causing any damage to the battery. You can retain the full energy storage capacity. You can design with no oversizing required. One of the other advantages of the flow batteries is that there's no thermal runaway. There's no danger of fire. The components they're made out of and the electrolyte are totally non-flammable. From a safety perspective, it gets the big tick of approval compared to, say, some other battery chemistries out there where thermal runaway is a real, real issue. Vanadium systems are much larger and provide a lower energy density. This means they have a much larger physical size, and therefore there's potential issues with floor loading, the weight of the system, the logistics of moving the system into place, and other installation issues. So what's on the horizon? Harvard researchers in 2017 developed a new flow battery which stores energy in organic molecules dissolved in neutral pH water. The molecules have been restructured, making them more water soluble. And this has resulted in a battery that loses only 1% of its capacity every 1,000 cycles. Conclusion: flow batteries use a liquid electrolyte. They don't mind being in a partial state of discharge. Effectively, the larger commercial systems use a vanadium-based solution. The energy density of these systems is similar to lead-based battery solutions. Thanks so much for watching our presentation on flow batteries. I hope you found it entertaining. I'm Veli from Greenwood Solutions. If you have any inquiries, any questions, or even any answers, please feel free to drop us a line. And if you like what you saw, hit that subscription button. Bye for now, and see you next time.